Welcome back to The Daily Hero, where we keep you up to date on all your comic book, movies, TV, video game, nerdy news, and all the fun stuff in between right here on The Hero Network. The much-anticipated Snyder Cut was originally advertised as a four-episode series of Zack Snyder's original version of the Justice League film that premiered back in late 2017. However, Zack Snyder himself has now said that that will no longer be a miniseries, but instead will be a four-hour-long movie. While filming the movie originally, Snyder had to step down and was replaced by Joss Whedon, who reshot and rewrote significant portions of the script. Ever since the Joss Whedon version came out and was received so poorly, fans have been eagerly campaigning for Snyder to have his own cut to be released. The Snyder Cut should release sometime this upcoming March exclusively on HBO Max. On Saturday, HBO Max released a short teaser that features all the Warner Brothers films that will be premiering on the service. They featured many brands and films, but we finally received the first look into the new Space Jam: A New Legacy. The film will clearly feature the full cast of Looney Tunes characters like with the original, and as seen in the brief teaser, but the main difference is the main character for this film will be LeBron James. Xbox announced that it is even asking fans to help design a new Space Jam game to launch alongside the film. A new Space Jam film has been rumored for almost a decade at this point, but we finally will be able to view the film on July 16th, 2021. Batwoman Season 2 premiered last night, and right away they addressed what happened to Kate Kane and how this show was going to be different from the past. Season 1 was cut short because of COVID, and things were starting to move in directions of a better character arc and a possible love story triangle for Kate, and even Alice was developing plans for the future, which now are all gone. Fans knew going into Season 2, Ruby Rose would not be coming back, so it was nice to see this transition episode from one Batwoman to another without officially killing off Kate, even though I doubt Ruby Rose will come back on the show. The premiere focused on Kate's disappearance and not enough on Ryan Wilder as the new Batwoman, so it's hard to tell if this new character will be forced into the plot already established in the show from Season 1, or if the show will completely write a new plot to fit this new character in her new world, which I think might happen, but the only difference will be they'll probably keep Alice in this new world, because Alice was one of the favorites in Season 1, and they are establishing Alice and Wilder already as almost enemies. That's all I got for you for today. Please give this video a like, and don't forget to subscribe and share so we can give you more nerdy goodness. Happy birthday, Janai! I'm Shelby at ShowPosted for The Daily Hero on The Hero Network. Please follow us on all social media at The Hero Network TV. Also send fan questions to HeroNetworkTV@gmail.com.